to a finite or an NFA, specifically an NFA. To an NFA. And this procedure is called the Thompson procedure. Or the Thompson construction. It's very straightforward. The idea is, what's a regular expression? A regular expression will have the symbols of the alphabet connected by union, star, and concatenation. And we know how to construct an NFA for the union, we know how to construct an NFA for the concatenation, and we know how to construct an NFA for the star. So given what we have studied for constructing NFAs for the union, the concatenation, and the star, and since the regular expression consists of symbols related by, you know, one of these, or a combination of these operations, regular operations, union, concatenation, star, we can easily construct in a straightforward manner an NFA for every regular expression. So let's study this by example. And let's look at this example. This is, by the way, it's going to be very straightforward. Construct an NFA for the following regular expression, which is AB union A, AB union A star. So the idea is, we certainly know how to construct an NFA for A. That's trivial. So this is an NFA for A. What does an NFA for A look like? What's an NFA that recognizes the language that consists of a single string, which is A by itself? What does that NFA look like?
Just start.
So just have a start state. And then if you get an A, you go to an accept state. This is a trivial NFA for accepting A by itself, and this is going to reject anything else, right? So this is going to be the building block. You can construct an NFA for a single symbol by itself, and this is an NFA for A. Then an NFA for B is going to be the same, or in a not the same, but can be done in a similar way. NFA for B is B accept. So now, the idea is that I have an NFA for A, I have an NFA for B, and then I have these operations. I know how to do an NFA for concatenation, I know how to do an NFA for union, I know how to do an NFA for star, then I can construct an NFA for this regular expression. So what should be the first regular operation that I should apply here?
Union?
Before the union. Okay. What's the first one in precedence? Now, okay. If you were to evaluate this expression, following the precedence rules, what's the first operation?
Okay.
This hidden concatenation here, right? So there is a concatenation. We said that we can drop the concatenation. So there is a concatenation here that we're hiding. So A concatenated with B, so we concatenate A with B. So we have an NFA for A, NFA for B, we concatenate them the way we just described. Then we use the rule for the union. We union that with A. Then we start the whole thing. Okay? So now, NFA for A concatenation B is going to be, what's the rule for concatenation? We connect them with an accept, and we change the accept states in the first language to non-accept states. So this is going to be A. Now this is no longer an accept state, then there is an epsilon, and then there is a B, and then there is an accept. So we just changed this to a non-accept state, which is very important. Okay, so now we have an NFA for this part of the expression. What should be the next step?
The union.
The union. So we union this with A. So we union the regular expression for A concatenated with B with a regular expression for A. And what's the rule for union, for constructing an NFA for the union?
Branch
on epsilon and just do the NFA for the first NFA, then the second NFA. That's it. So, okay, and then epsilon, and then A union B, or A concatenation B, sorry. A, epsilon, B, accept, AB. And then the other one is A. Okay, so this is an NFA for the union. This is NFA for AB union A. Now, what's the last operation?
Star.
So how do we construct an NFA for the star?
A quad transition out of the
state.
Exactly. I add the start state. So this is a start state that I add. And is it an accept state?
Yes.
It's an accept state. So I add this start state. Then what do I do?
You have epsilon from the last two accept states go to the second.
To this or to the original start state?
Original.
To the original. So that's the idea. So it goes, they will go, the epsilons are going to go back to the original start state, not to the start state that I have added. So this is epsilon. Yeah, definitely. So we take these, we do these epsilon transitions back from every accept state to the original start state. Yes. Okay, any questions? So the idea is intuitive. Once you know how to construct NFAs for union, star, and concatenation, you can construct an NFA for any regular expression. So this proves that any language that can be expressed using a regular expression will have an NFA, which means that any language that can be generated by a regular expression is necessarily a regular language, because we can construct an NFA for it. And in fact, there are transitions in the other direction, by the way, so there are ways of the conversions. We can convert a DFA into a regular expression, but we're not going to study that. It's enough to study these conversions that are actually used. These are the conversions that are actually used in the construction of a compiler, as we will see later. So converting an NFA into a DFA, then converting a regular expression into an NFA. In fact, in a compiler, the way compilers are constructed is that you first define a regular expression to define the syntax, the microsyntax of a language. Then you convert that NFA, you convert that regular expression into an NFA using this procedure, the Thompson construction. Then you take that NFA and you convert it into a DFA using the subset construction that we have studied. Then you have a DFA. And why do you think in compilers we want things to get converted into a DFA eventually? Because a DFA is straightforward to implement. It's straightforward to implement a DFA. It's just a lookup table.